Hi. Today, let's learn about not-for-profit organizations. How do they keep accounts? You know, there are so many organizations around us which have been formed not for profit, but for promotion of culture, of literature, of religion, etc., etc., or to just help people. So therefore, how do they keep accounts? Or why do they really keep accounts? Is the question that should come to your mind. They keep accounts mainly to know the financial position, to know how they are performed, and also to make sure that the money has been used for the purpose that they have been collected. The financial statements of a not-for-profit organization are three. One, they have a receipts and payments account. Two, income and expenditure account. And three, the balance sheet. Receipts and payments account is prepared just to know the movement of funds, from where the money has come and where the money has been spent. An easy statement for any reader. Even if he has not done commerce, he will be able to appreciate this statement, because everybody understands the language of money, from where it came and where it has been spent. But if you want to know actually whether I have made surplus or not, a performance appraisal of a not-profit organization would come from the income and expenditure account. And a financial position statement is the balance sheet, just like for other organizations. Now, what do you need to know from the examination point of view? In the 2 marks question, generally you are asked terms. For example, what is a capital fund? A capital fund is nothing but the difference between the assets and liabilities of a non-profit organization. For a profit-making organization, asset minus liabilities is capital. Here it is going to be capital fund. What are subscriptions? Subscriptions are the regular payments made by the members of the association according to its bylaws to keep their membership going. What are donations? Amounts received towards the objectives of the organization. What are legacies? Legacies are amounts left by the will of deceased persons. People who die, they leave a will. They'll write in the will that this money should go to this particular organization. So from the organization point of view, it will be a legacy received. So such questions, some simple questions would come for 2 marks. Let me look at the 5 mark question. Usually there are 3 types of questions that come. The first one would be how to prepare a receipts and payments account. And the second one would be how to calculate the capital fund. And third one is classification of items between revenue and capital. So let me start with the first type. That is, I am going to teach you how to prepare a receipts and payments account. A little while ago, I said a receipt and payment account is nothing but a statement that explains from where the money has come and where the money has been spent. It's money, cash in hand. It means debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Okay? So whatever is the receipts, money that is received by the organization during that particular period is going to be put on the left side, on the debit side, called the receipt side. And whatever it pays is going to be put on the right side, which is the credit side or the payment side.